CMC. This is the space that we usually give to acknowledge the land that we're on, to acknowledge the people, the original custodians of this land, the Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, Chippewa, Mississauga, the Credit, and I'm missing one, I think. Wendat, Chippewa, Mississauga, the Credits. The sort of awkwardness I sometimes feel with having to give a land acknowledgement is that I want it to be more than just rote. I don't want to just say it. I want us to think about what happens after these words come out, when we leave this space every day, when we wake up, and think about the horrific and violent events that came for our country to be what it is now, and to not forget that in the sort of context of the horrific and violent events that are happening right now in our world today. So I encourage you, not only at the beginning of a performance or when you read it on the side of a building, but to really think about it and take time every day to just, I don't know, sit with those feelings, because they're pretty heavy, they're intense, and we're here now, and I know that there is a lot that we can all do beyond just saying these words. So I definitely have very strong feelings, and I'm sure they're shared all over. And so, yeah, I encourage us all to sort of move beyond just the words and to think about the world we live in today, how we got here and where we're going. I'm really, really excited that we're all here today for this performance in this space. Thank you very much to Joseph Glasser for inviting us here. We have a few further shows in CMC Presents, as well as in the jazz program. April the 4th is David Acapinti with strings. That will happen here. April 30th is the Jazz Presents. I'm blanking on her name. Nikki?
Schreier.
Yeah, so that will happen April 30th. And May 9th will be the final one, featuring Tuku and Nick Dorado. Tuku is a vocalist and Nick Dorado is a multi-instrumentalist that will be performing a number of pieces. And so in thinking about this ensemble tonight, as well as the rest of the season that I've curated, it's sort of meant to think about the different ways we can approach composition, what that means. It's an organization of things. How is that communicated? Who is it for? What could it be? It could be a lot of different things. And I'm particularly interested in the sort of space where composition and improvisation sort of meet and engage with each other. And they seem like sort of maybe opposites, but also not. They all also work together in process, in creation. Anyway, so what we've got tonight for you is, I'm really excited because it's the start, hopefully, of something that will continue to run, which is an ensemble at U of T that is sort of dealing with exactly that. So what kinds of compositions and what kinds of improvisations within compositions, what kinds of compositions can come out of improvisation, all of those sort of realms. And I am very excited to see what they have in store. I mean, I saw the set list. I think that there was some work done by Patrick where we sort of took a look at some of the catalog or the library, scores in the library here. And so some of that you'll hear tonight. And yeah, without further ado, here's the dog ensemble. Woo!
Thank you.
Thank you. Da 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 ya da ba. Da 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 ba. Ba. Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I see some of the, I'm so curious about the